raw, unadulterated, uncontrolled, disgusting, busted. You want to touch it too high, you forgot.
Just over the river from Windsor, Ontario, we're in downtown Detroit at lovely Comerica Park. Today, it's an American League Central Division matchup between the Kansas City Royals and the Detroit Tigers. Live baseball here on MLB Network, and it comes your way next. Matthew Boyd gets the ball in Game 3 of the series. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a look at Matt Boyd. And, you know, one of the keys for Matt Boyd when he's good, he has that slider, and that's his binky. That's his bread and butter. He needs to have that to be successful. He struggles at times giving up multiple hits and innings. One of the keys, establish the strike zone early to give him a chance to use that good hard slider.
And stepping in, Whit Merrifield. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. First delivery to him. And afternoon baseball on MLB Network is underway. So, fellas, these Tigers, as they begin play here today, they dropped another one last time out, and, in fact, they've won just twice in their last eight tries.
Yeah, Matty B. Hey, D-Row, we're looking at a team that's playing some pretty good baseball right now. Through the first five games of this homestand, 4-1, and looking for some bigger and better things.
Yeah, we had a chance to sit down before the game after BP with the manager. He was really pleased with the way his team has played in these last five. Let's see if it continues today.
Now the 2-0.
Nasty 2-0 slider right there for a strike. No shame in tipping your hat.
The 2-1 home. And a little off to begin the afternoon as it's to 3-1 now.
Yeah, a little wild here early on. Doesn't look like he's totally settled into the game yet. Hopefully he can find it soon.
The 3-1. Skied into straightaway right. Burke is in his tracks now. One gone.
Batting second, the third baseman, Adalberto Mondesi.
Now into the box, Adalberto Mondesi. Lifetime numbers against Matt Boyd. He's got 8 hits in 29 at-bats. And of those hits, 3 of them were of the home run variety. In there for strike one.
What a well-executed fastball right there, down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that thing.
So let's take a peek at the umpiring crew working this one. Behind the plate is Eric Summersgill.
You know what, Dan? I'm always baffled when Eric Summersgill's behind the dish because he has a tendency to favor one side of the plate.
You know, that's one of the things I think pitchers get a little bit frustrated with the E-train at time. It's like, hey, if you're going to give me that inside quarter, give it to me, but don't keep moving the dish around on me all game.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
The count now at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch.
Three balls, two strikes.
Nicky Lopez waits on deck. Top of the first, just underway here in Motown. And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away.
And that's the beauty of having a guy in the two-hole like him. He's almost like another leadoff hitter, working a walk with just one out. And I think there's a good chance that he's going to be on the move at some point.
And now here is Nicky Lopez. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. From the stretch, here's the pitch. And this one's in the dirt. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch. Into the corner and slicing foul. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
It's so hard to hit when you're behind the count 0-2, right? You have to protect from the fastball. You have to look for the soft stuff down and away. You're really at a disadvantage when you fall behind 0-2.
into the box now. Jesus Sanchez in the dirt here, and no advance. It's ball one. One and oh, here it is. Runner breaks for third. Pitch is a called strike. The throw, not in time, as he just does get in there ahead of the throw.
You know, I was pretty surprised to see him on the move to third because it didn't seem like he had that much of a lead, but he made it work out. That was really impressive.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Laker is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. One left for Kansas City. Nothing for Kansas City in the first. The Tigers do up. You're watching MLB Network. Brady Singer gets the ball for the Royals in this one. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a chance to look at a guy that's been pretty good his last three starts. A whip under 1.20, so he minimizes the amount of base runners. He's a tough customer. It'll be fun to watch him to see if he's on point early in this one here today.
Stepping up is Corey Madison. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Hit back up the middle. Fielded cleanly. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play.
Batting second, the center fielder, Tristan Laker.
Next for the Tigers, Tristan Laker. And he really thrives in the batter's box here at home. Something to keep an eye on in this one. Now the first pitch. Hit the other way out toward right field. Sanchez is there now, and it's two pitches, two out.
Batting third.
Now it'll be Christian Pena. He's two for seven in the series so far. Here's the first pitch. These Kansas City Royals entering play this afternoon, guys. They come in looking to make it two in a row as they were winners last time out.
Hey, thanks, Matty. Hey, you know what, D-Ro? Try to get on a kind of a little mini winning streak here. Losing the first game of this series, winning game two, and hopefully winning this series by pulling one out here today.
Yeah, Dan, they were able to shower that first loss off in the first game of this series and had a nice bounce back game yesterday. Let's see if they can steal a series right here.
One and two now as that one's fouled off. Started to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third and ring him up, says the third base umpire. He's gone. Down in order go the Tigers. Still no score. And that'll bring up the left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi. Lifetime numbers against Matt Boyd. He's batting 500, 6 for 12. Two of those hits were for home runs. First offering on its way. Check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. He pulls this one into right, into a slide, and he makes a great catch for the first down.
Batting sixth, the first baseman, Carlos.
Ready now is Carlos Santana, as the switch hitter will bat right-handed here.
Hey, this guy handles lefties pretty well. Is that above 300 batting average to test? He swings it really good from the right side.
And a good fastball there, but this just misses the zone for ball one. Skied into straightaway right. And two quick outs here in the second. So to get his day started at the plate, Michael Taylor trying to get it going at the plate. It's been tough sledding for him so far this year. First pitch of the AB on its way. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside. That evens it up, 1-1. Here it comes. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Still looking for our first hit in the ballgame. Smoke toward third. And the throw won't be in time as he'll be able to beat out the recovery throw at first.
That's the cat and mouse of the game right there. You find yourself count leverage. You think you're getting a heater. He throws an off-speed pitch and you're still able to execute. That fires me up right there.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez. He gets a shot to hit here in the inning following the two-out single.
Yeah, and that hit might not amount to much, but anytime you can extend an inning and give a guy with plenty of pop a chance to swing it, the outlook of an inning changes dramatically.
Now a move over to first. A dive, but he's back. First pitch on its way. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Taylor, the runner at first with two gone. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Lifetime numbers against Matt Boyd. He's collected 11 hits in 39 at-bats. He's also hit a couple of home runs against him. Three and oh now.
He's really going to need to keep the walks down in this start. He's in danger of walking the second guy in two innings here.
Here it comes on 3-0. Now an off-speed pitch gets the outside. It's a called strike. Ready on 3-1. Here it comes. Down the third baseline. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Royals leave one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Is Pierre Santiago. He'll start us out here in the home half of the second.
Pierre Santiago.
Here's the first pitch to him.
1-0.
Into his windup. Here comes the 1-0. Swing and a miss. Blew it right by him at 96. It's a ball and a strike. 2-1. Hitters count now. Here's the 2-1.
That's a great sinker right there. These batters are going to have to bear down because if he's got that good pitch working, it's going to be a long game. They might have to sit off speed.
And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. And it's fouled away. The next 3-2. It's a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
A lot of indecision there on that check swing, and that's something you see quite a lot on 3-2. When the difference between striking out and drawing a walk and can be an inch or two, it's pretty understandable why guys aren't always aggressive with their swings.
And now the first pitch. Elijah Burke comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0.
A ball and a strike. Singer has become known as a guy that's tough to take deep. So many starting pitchers find themselves snake bitten by the gopher ball, but he really limits that.
In this day and age of smaller ballparks, the ball's lively, the bats are harder. This guy does a great job of keeping the ball in the ballpark. And one of the keys, he's not predictable. He'll throw his off-speed pitches behind an account. He's really difficult to sit on just one pitch.
Bottom of the second here with no score. And another foul ball. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
One thing to take note of is how these last two batters have really driven up his pitch count. He's had to use 14 pitches already on them, and he's not even through this guy yet. 14 is near the top end of what you want to throw in a complete inning.
Hit hard on the ground to the right. Merrifield brings it in, and there's out number two. So to get his day started at the plate, Manny Vizcaíno trying to get it going at the plate. It's been tough sledding for him so far this year. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Now a check swing, but he holds up in time. Ball one.
They say the toughest pitch in baseball is a located fastball. I disagree. That nasty slider is tough to hold up on.
Drilled right back up the middle. And the Tigers are into the hit column now. That's their first hit of the contest.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
At the plate, Kobe Popboy. Pitch inside. The throw. Not in time as he steals second. Well, the stolen base is that close, it's interesting to check it out on ShowTrack. And as the numbers come in, you'll want to focus on the top speed. Really good, and it paid off there. The 1-0. That's inside. 2-0.
Now, you can see he's working around this guy right here. Why not? First base is open. Walk wouldn't be the worst thing in this spot.
Two balls and a strike to the Tigers' first baseman.
Great job by the pitcher right there, changing eye levels. We all know he's a sinker ball pitcher, but if he could throw some four-seamers up in the zone like that, it could work for him.
Hit weakly back to the mound. And the stolen base winds up as a moot point as the inning is over. Tigers leave one. We'll move to the third with no score. Top of the third set to get underway, and that'll bring up Hunter Dozier.
The designated hitter, Hunter Dozier.
And now the first pitch. A ball and no strikes. Strike to even the count. 1-1.
The offense better get it going right here because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
The 2-1. Will not catch the zone. Ball three.
You could pretty much book it that a fastball's coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the nine-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order looming.
The 3-1 pitch. And he lays off there. Ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
And that's what you want from your leadoff hitter. Shows some great patience and discipline, making the pitcher labor to start the game. The result is a leadoff walk and a chance to make some early noise.
Whit Merrifield next to hit. As he'll take a look at ball one. He flied out leading off the ball game. can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. From the belt, kicks and deals. Count is 1-2 now. Dozier aboard here at first with nobody out. And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Little chopper back to the mound. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And they still manage to get an out on the play. Whoa. And now in the box, Adalberto Mondesi hitting 500 in the series so far. 4-for-8. First pitch on the way. Breaking ball for a strike. 0-1. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1.
Well, that backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's a very effective pitch. If you can hit the outside corner of that pitch, it's unhittable.
Two balls and a strike now. Now the 2-1 pitch.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
Now back.
So next to hit is Nicky Lopez, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Got to find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
1-0. Here it is.
Hey, I don't mind that batter taking that strike right there. He's walked a couple people early in this game. Got to find out if he can find the zone. If he wants to walk them all in, we'll take it.
Third inning, no score to this point. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul.
Yeah, Matty, you see the same pitch three times in a row and you find yourself down 1-2 in the count. Your head starts to get on a swivel here. Is he coming back with it four times, or do I have to sit on something else?
Here's the 1-2. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Bottom of the inning now, and next will be the speedy catcher, Austin Jones.
The catcher, Austin Jones.
Now here's the first offering.
Outside, that's the ball.
The 1-0 is looked at for the first strike.
Hey, boys, he's lucky he's getting this pitch back right here. That's normally a wipeout pitch down and away. He hung that one. It looked like he almost confused the hitter.
Two balls and a strike to count. The 2-1 home. Hit on the ground after short. He's got it. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
Batting done.
Next to dig in, Ben Waller. He's got 0 for his first 6 at-bats in the series so far. Now here it comes. Bottom of inning number 3, 0-0 our score. Ball 2. Two and one after the foul ball there. And a good pitch there as this ball swung on and popped straight up the chute right around home plate. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out. Digging in will be Corey Maddison, grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
And this winds up inside for a ball. 2-0 now.
It's a lot easier to hit when you're putting yourself in good hitters' counts. This guy's done a great job not swinging at pitchers' pitches. And when he's getting the ball in the zone, he's getting the barrel to it. He's been hot lately.
And it's 2-1 to the Tigers' leadoff hitter. Into the windup and the pitch.
Down to 3-1.
I don't blame him for not coming over the heart of the plate. He circled this guy on the lineup card when he got to the yard today. He's been swinging one of the hotter bats in the game.
Bases are empty here with two men out. 3-2.
3-2.
And he takes ball four, so he's on. And as you know, that often means the steal could be in order here.
Man, you hate to give up a two-out walk to anybody, but especially to a speed demon like him. Good chance he's running here, and good luck trying to stop him.
Next up is Tristan Laker, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch.
No doubt this is a steal situation right here. Two outs and the leadoff hitter on first. This is the time you roll the dice and hope he gets in the scoring position where he can get a hit to bring him home.
Looks at a sinker there that drops in 1-1. Strike taken as that one crosses over the inside part of the plate.
He's looking pretty passive here, hitting with a chance to drive in a run. Gonna have to make something happen with two strikes now.
The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. One left for Detroit. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. New inning set to get underway, and digging in is the outfielder, Jesus Sanchez.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
This one's down to third. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Now batting, the left fielder, Andrew Benintendi.
The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one. And this one's in the dirt. Good job keeping it close as the count goes to 1-1. He waits. Now the pitch. Oh, they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Boy, that's a jam shot right there. That's as good as it gets, in my opinion. Woo! Up and in.
Here comes the 1-2.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
Three and two now. On deck, Carlos Santana. Sanchez on at first, nobody out. And he will take ball four. First and second now with nobody out.
Up next,
well, they've struggled
boys.
Offensively in this the one so far, but after that walk, they've got runners at first and second and look ready to make a little noise. Just need a big hit now.
So now here is Carlos Santana, flew out in his only at-bat so far. Here's the first pitch to him. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
Little traffic on the base paths right here, but one pitch away from getting a double play and getting right back into control.
No runs, two hits, and no errors so far for the Royals. And he'll look at a fastball just off the black, and it's even at one. High and deep down the left field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Hit in the air to right field. Burke is there to put it away for out number one. And he'll indeed move up 90 feet, putting runners at the corners now with one away.
Good read there at second base to know he could make it to third on the flyout. Now he's only 90 feet away with one out.
One away for the Royals here in the fourth. And that means batting next will be the center fielder, Michael A. Taylor. He's set. Here it comes. Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike.
Hey, this is a spot as a pitcher right now you want to get a little bit greedy. Ideal would be to roll up a two ball. At worst, try to get yourself a strikeout.
Lifted down the line in left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Fastball just misses. That's ball one.
I mean, he's coming right after him, Matty. Three fastballs in a row.
Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's two and two.
All right, no more hoping he's going to chase. It's two and two now. You've got to come up with the best pitch right here because this is definitely a strikeout situation.
Ground ball to second. This could be two. To second for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Like clockwork. A 4-6-3 double play to end the threat. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. Now to bat, Christian Pena. He'll start things out here in a tie ball game.
The designated hitter, Christian Pena.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. 2-0.
You can see this guy's more focused at the plate right now. In that first AB, he went down on strikes.
The 2-0 on the way. Nope. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
Hard hit at third. And there's one down now.
Now back.
Next to hit is Pierre Santiago. Comes into this at bat 0-1 in the ballgame. First pitch on its way. And a good slider here to start the at bat, but it's ruled a ball. 1-0. Tough to do much with that one. A swing and a miss.
Really deceptive changeup right there. It died right before the plate, and he was left reaching for air.
The count now at 2-1. Into the windup and the pitch. Fouled away. Another try at 2-2. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Going to need to make a little bit of an adjustment with a slider release and at least tempt the hitter that it's going to be a strike.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
This guy is really locked in on the bump right now. He's just playing good old-fashioned hardball right now. Just rearing back and letting it go. And it seems like this lineup, they don't have an answer for anything he's bringing so far.
Stepping in now, Elijah Burke. As the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. And that gets the black on the outside. A good slider that time.
Hey, he's got great feel for that pitch right there. He can throw it anytime he wants for a strike.
Inside and low, 2-1. No runs, just one hit, and no errors in the ballgame for the Tigers. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Liner toward right center. A dive, but it's off his glove. The throw into second. The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. Three up, three down for Detroit. Through four, still tied, nothing. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Well, Matt, Royals manager Mike Matheny talked with me in between innings about his lineup's offensive production, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. They've already worked out three walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
All right, thanks, Heidi. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And up next, the former World Series hero, Salvador Perez. Here's the first pitch. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
2-0 now. The pitch. Here's a swing and a long drive high in the air and deep to center field. Way out of here into the upper row of bushes. Wow. So it's a solo shot to dead center. Sixth home run on the season for him, and the Royals are on the board first. It's 1-0.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in a game.
Up next to the Royals.
And that brings in Hunter Dozier. As the first pitch here is a bit high, it's ball one. He enters here right at the 290 mark. Five homers and a dozen RBIs. And this one's too far inside, ball two. In the dirt, it's 3-0 now.
Well, he knows it, but this is the kind of guy you just have to go right after. He's not the biggest threat with the bat, so it's time to challenge him right here.
3-1.
He must know something we don't know. That was a center cut heater with count leverage in a big spot. I don't understand why he's taken.
3-2 to the Royals' designated hitter. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Now batting, the second baseman, Rick
Whit Merrifield next to bat. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Now the slider gets the call in the bottom part of the zone.
If you're on the mound right here, you got to trust your catcher and execute. You know who's coming up to the plate.
In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Dozier gets his lead at first. Nobody out. This is popped up. Pop boy is over, and he puts it away for the first out. Now at the plate here is Adalberto Mondesi. He's 0 for 1 thus far. First offering. In the dirt here. And a nice job keeping it close. It's ball one. Some action now in the Tigers' bullpen as they'll get a left-hander and a right-hander up to throw. On the move for second, hit to third, and that's the second out. Now to the plate, Nicky Lopez, runner in scoring position with two gone. Looking to keep this a one-run game. The pitch, and this one's in the dirt, and no advance. It's ball one. Ready with the 1-0. And he watches one miss outside. 2-0 now.
A couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Swing and a liner. Laker will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. One scores in the inning, coming on this solo home run. Middle of the afternoon here at Comerica Park. It's now 1-0 Royals. I got it. I'm good. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Well, Matt, during the break, I caught up with the Tigers manager to discuss his thoughts on Detroit's offense. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. No, they have not scored yet, but they have been successful in running up the pitch count, something they feel will eventually pay dividends on the scoreboard as the starter gets tired and they are forced to go to the bullpen. For now, they're sticking to the plan.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Now at the plate, Manny Vizcaíno. He leads off in the bottom of the fifth as they look to break through on the scoreboard for the first time in this one.
Yeah, no doubt about it. You can tell in between innings the veterans in that dugout going up and down the line, trying to keep this lineup from getting super frustrated. They just have to find a way to piece it together, maybe pass the baton, get some wheels in motion, maybe get aggressive on the base pass if they can get somebody on.
Line drive, base hit down the line. Throw into second. Not in time, and he's in there with a double. Finally, a little something for them to get excited about.
Yeah, a rally can begin with a single swing of the bat, and this might be their chance right here. They've struggled to produce a lot of runs, but there he is at second base. A shot to the outfield scores him. Then who knows what kind of roll they could get on. Got to take it one good at-bat at a time.
Into the box, Kobe Popboy, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Waiting on it is Benintendi, and that's the first out of the inning. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base. Striding in is Austin Jones. A base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Vizcaíno, the runner at second with one away. A throw behind the runner at second, and he'll dive back in safely. And he'll turn and throw back to second again. And a dive, but he's back in there. One and one to count. Has a look, now the pitch. Bounce to first. Oh, it takes a nasty hop, and he's unable to haul it in. And on the error, a run is going to score.
Hey, we're in the middle of this one already, D-Row. They finally score a run, and they've had a tough time scoring some runs.
Yeah, after taking it on the chin yesterday, it's nice to finally break through. Maybe this gives the offense the confidence it needs.
First things first, here's the throw over, and he'll dive back in. To the plate now, Ben Waller. Pitch out, nothing doing. And a slider just about gets away from him there as it runs in a bit too close for comfort.
Pretty easy takes to start out this at bat. None of those pitches were even close to the strike zone.
The 2-0 on the way.
Three balls, one strike.
Corey Madison will be next. The 3-1 pitch. Weak roller right side. One there. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. Tigers get one here on two hits in the inning. At the plate now is Jesus Sanchez. He's batting cleanup in this one, but we'll get us started here in the inning as they look to wake up the bats.
Yeah, not much to get excited about with just a single notch on the scoreboard, but you have to give credit to where it's deserved. The pitching on the other side has been really impressive.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch.
Hey, it's not always about filling up the strike zone all the time every inning. He's pitching well as we're moving into the middle innings, but interestingly, less than 50% of his first pitches have been for strikes.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Well, pitching domination continues. Just a total of two runs on the board, so both of these starters should feel really good about their showings. If you love good pitching, this has been the game for you.
Standing in now, Andrew Benintendi. As he'll ground this one fouled off to the left side. It was a walk in his last trip. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Whoa, that pitch is out.
One out, nobody on. High in the air out to center field. And quickly, two are gone now here in the visitors' half of the sixth.
Now back.
Here's Carlos Santana now, 0-2 on the afternoon so far. Now here's the first offering. Really feels like he's just on cruise control out there on the mound right now.
Boy, this is a tight one. You kind of get the feeling like the next team that scores is going to win this one.
And it's 1-1. Two out, nobody on. 2-1 to the Royals first baseman. Now the 2-1. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Royals go down 1-2-3. Still tied, one apiece.
Is this redemption for my soul?
Chris Bubich enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 50, Chris Bubich.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Corey Madison.
The shortstop.
Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. A ball and no strikes.
Good spot to be in right now as a hitter. Count your favor, 1-0. Good time to get a fastball and turn it loose.
And this misses as it moves to 2-0 now on the Tigers shortstop.
Boy, you don't see that very often out of a rookie. That's a 2-0 count, and both of those pitches were really close. This guy has a pretty good eye.
Outside, 3-0 now.
Well, he was definitely looking fastball here, and he got one. But that was good discipline to lay off and get himself into a 3-0 count.
3-1. Fouled off. The 3-2 pitch. And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
Up next, Tristan Laker, who went down on strikes in his last at-bat. Now the first pitch. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
This is a tough guy to turn two on. It's got to be hit hard. If you're an infielder, you've got to catch it and get rid of it quickly.
The 1-0. Runner goes for second. Offered at and missed. Here's the throw. And it's going to be in time as Perez fired a strike to get him that time.
Wow, that's a big-time throw right there. And it's a tall task to throw him out stealing a bag. But he got rid of it quickly, and it was a good job down there applying the quick tag. They'll have to feel good about that
one. Now the 1-1 pitch. A dive, and he knocks it down. And no chance at a recovery here, as despite a great effort that time, they won't get it out on the play.
Dan, after that base hit right there, he's got a six-game hit streak going.
You know what? And this could lead him on to some bigger and better things right here. He's been swinging the bat pretty well, and he's been rewarded for it, as you talked about. Six-game hitting streak so far.
Christian Pena comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. Laker leads off first with one away.
He's going.
He's running. Pitch outside. The throw. He is not in time. Pretty close, but he got in there safely. Certainly a very close play at second on that bag, so let's analyze it with Showtrack. We all know he's got plus speed on his side, and you really see it represented in the top speed. That really made the difference on that one. 1-1 is in there for the second strike. Runner at second here with one man out. Lifted the other way down the left field line. Benintendi in pursuit. He gets there, and that's the second out. So the next to bat will be Pierre Santiago. Struck out in his last trip to the plate. Here's the first pitch to him. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. And there's ball one. High and deep to left. This one's got plenty of distance. And they take the lead. It's gone. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. Fourth home run for him on the season. And with it, the Tigers have been staked to a 3-1 lead.
I can tell you one thing. You might get away with throwing a ball in that location in the minor leagues, but when you get one up like that in the zone right over the plate against these guys, you're going to get exactly what he got, a really bad result.
At the plate now,
the right
Elijah
fielder, number
Burke.
Seven.
Elijah.
As he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. And that's right there, and we're even at one. Bases are empty here with two men out. And that one yanked just foul. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. The Tigers do get a couple, however, on this two-run home run. Bottom third of the order, 7-8-9, due up to start the seventh. It's now 3-1 Tigers. Richard Rodriguez is on the pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 49, Richard Rodriguez.
Leading off the inning, it'll be Michael Taylor as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. Now the first pitch.
Hey, you want someone sometimes to rattle the bat rack. But also, the guy on the mound's got to eat, too. They're executing their pitches out there. It's going to be tough to score some runs.
Now, here it comes.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
A ball and two strikes now. Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand. So they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
And up steps Salvador Perez. Popped him up. Madison is there. Two gone.
Now batting.
So next to the plate for the Royals, Hunter Dozier. His prior history in this matchup. Small sample, a perfect one for one. And now pitch on the way. Hit hard toward the right side. That gets down, and the inning will continue. And this will kick off the base of the wall. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
Well, it isn't exactly earth-shattering, but when you struggle like they have at the plate all day, you take any extra base hit that you can get. If they can string together a few at-bats like that, they're going to get right back into this thing.
So the Royals batting order turns over and set to go. Whit Merrifield. And Dan, what's the plan of attack here for the guy on the mound?
Well, I think they have to go right after him. He's pretty unlikely to take you deep, but if you allow him to get on base, the chances of him scoring and tying this game become a lot greater.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Count 1-0.
Dozier at second with two down.
Ball.
Two balls and no strikes.
With two outs and a base open, I don't think he's going to see anything to hit in this at bat. Not much reason for it.
The 2-0 on the way. Is laid off, but in there for strike one.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
We're in the seventh inning with a good finish brewing. 3-1 our score. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And the count will be full. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. That's popped up. Pop Boy trying to get there, and this is going to wind up a foul ball. The next 3-2. And a slider swung on and missed, and the side is retired. So they can't make anything out of the two-out double. Back with more of this Thursday afternoon business person special following this. So stepping in is Manny Vizcaíno. He doubled his last time up.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
And he fouls this one off. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. Popped him up. And this is going to fall. He can't flag it down. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. A bouncer up the middle. Reined in. And there's one away. Next up, Kobe Popboy. He flew out in his last AB.
Almost, Maddie. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
One ball, no strikes to count. Lifted down the line and left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Two balls, one strike, the count.
Great job of doubling up with a fastball inside. A lot of times you'll see a pitcher go in there, but they won't go back in there a second time. This guy's not afraid to pitch inside.
Swing, and there it goes. He got all of that ball. And this one is gone, a home run. A solo shot down the line and right, number 10 for him on the year. And the Tigers have taken a 4-1 lead.
Hey, that that's the price you pay right there when you try and sneak a fastball past this guy. Power hitter, and every power hitter in the league knows you got to start with the numero uno, number one, man. You got to get on the heater and adjust to everything else, and he did just that.
Jacob Junis is going to come on in relief as he'll be making his 20th appearance of the season.
Number 24.
Into the box now, Austin Jones.
The catcher, Austin.
As he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. One for two in the ball game thus far. Bounced softly in front of the plate. Throw gets him, two down.
Now
to the plate here is Ben Waller. 0 for 2 on his line thus far. First pitch of the AB on its way. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now, 0-2.
Man, when you're struggling at the plate, that pitcher smells blood in the water. He's coming right after you, trying to end it quick.
Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
Love the high heater right there to raise the hitter's sights. Let's see if he buries something in the dirt right here.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it, 2-2.
When a pitcher's close to working through a quick inning, that's when you really need to grind out some at-bats. He's done a good job of that, and that's really big when you're hitting towards the bottom of the order.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
And it's fouled away. Another full count pitch home. Line toward the gap in left center. That gets down and the inning continues.
Dan, how frustrating that must be. Eight pitch at bat and he's able to work a base hit.
D-Row, he threw everything but the kitchen sink at him. He threw off-speed pitches, fastballs, and on the eighth pitch, left one out over the plate. Just enough for a base hit.
In now, Corey Madison. And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. And this one will bounce into the wall. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double. Well, it took him till the seventh, but he gets his first hit of the game here, and that'll extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, and he didn't come out of what he was trying to do all day, Dan. Kept the front shoulder tough, kept the ice water in his veins, and didn't try and get too big. Extends the hitting streak. Nice job.
You know, D-Ro, I talked to him before the game about the streak, and he said the toughest part is he hopes to get hits early in the game to take the pressure off. He had to wait to the seventh inning in this one to come through.
Tristan Laker is at the plate as he watches ball one. Waller on third. Madison on at second with two down. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Santana trying to get there, and no one will get this one. Here's the 1-1.
I think he's shown you right there. He was trying to put you away with the off-speed pitch. Have to be leery of that right there and take pull side away. That'll keep you on all stuff, fastballs and the off-speed.
And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
He really needs to find a pitch to put this guy away with right here, right now. He can't allow this inning to get any worse than it's already become.
He set the payoff pitch. Lifted in the air to center. Taylor gets there for the catch, and that ends the inning. But add on one more as the solo shot stretches their lead even further. We're through seven this afternoon. It's now 4-1 Detroit. Leo Holly has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 25, Leo Holly.
Leading off the inning, it'll be Adalberto Mondesi, and they could use a spark from him here.
Adalberto Mondesi.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Swing and a miss, 0-1. He comes up empty that time as he's underneath it, 0-2.
Get it ready, big boy. This guy's throwing three digits right here. The best way I can help the fans is 90 to 92, you can usually see seams. 92 to 95, it starts to really quicken up on you. Over three digits, you're seeing a white blur.
They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. That was a nasty-looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. A classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
So now to the plate, Nicky Lopez. 1-0 the count. Now the pitch. Holly, just 24 years of age. This is his first year at the big league level. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Laker is there now, and he has it, two gone. So here is Jesus Sanchez, two away here in the eighth, and time's running out on him, Danny.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of outs left to work with, so it's time for someone to make something happen if they're going to get back into this thing.
First pitch on its way. The 1-0. Count now a ball and a strike. And he takes a cold strike two.
We're going to see him throw that hard fastball early and often.
Slider whiffed on for strike three. A great pitch. Put an end to the end. Josh Mont is on to pitch out of the